there's perhaps no moment in life more likely to provoke awe and wonder than birth. It's consistently extraordinary to connect the passion and intimacy of the circumstances that lead to conception with the minute detail of how an embryo develops, and with the mystery of how that embryo becomes a human person. It's instructive to note the ancient term procreation, which identifies the way human beings get to participate in the wondrous work of God in creation. It's as if this most precious moment is delegated to complex and fallible humanity. By contrast, the modern word for the same process is reproduction, a term that resonates with the language of the factory, always tending to see birth as the result of human production rather than the gift of God's creation. John Rutter captures the human and divine mystery of Jesus' birth in his Nativity Carol.
Oh.
when Matthew introduces the birth of Jesus, he uses a very interesting word, Genesis. He's presenting Jesus' virginal conception as equivalent to the creation of all things in the first chapter of the Bible. The notion of birth as being principally a movement of God and only secondarily one of human initiation does not begin with Jesus. Old Testament figures Isaac, Jacob, Moses, Samson, and Samuel are all described as having been conceived by God's intervention. God tells Jeremiah, "Before I formed you in the womb, I knew you." Most movingly, Psalm 139 extends this sense of deliberate purpose to each one of us. "It was you who formed my inward parts. You knit me together in my mother's womb." In his 1945 hymn, Albert Bailey struggles to reconcile the ancient mystery of glory with the modern technology of science. O Lord of every shining constellation. The Bible is full of metaphors of birth. They cluster into two themes, both of which are close to human experience. One is the dawn of salvation. Famously, Jesus says to Nicodemus, "You must be born again." In other words, biological birth isn't the same as the regeneration only the Holy Spirit can bring about. The other set of metaphors is suffering and deliverance. The pain of childbirth is regarded as the result of the fall. Isaiah and Jeremiah compare the struggle for redemption as like the groaning of childbirth. And Paul in Romans 8 speaks of the whole creation experiencing labour pains. Jesus himself uses the same metaphor to encourage the disciples that the time of struggle will in due course be displaced by joy. Malcolm Archer's setting of a prayer of St. Richard of Chichester is such a plea for faithfulness amid adversity.